Васудевая. Ом намо Бхагавате Васудевая. Ом намо Бхагавате Васудевая. Шримад Бхагаватам Кенто Тен, which is called Summum Bonum, and chapter number 49, which is called Акрура's Mission in Хастинапура, verse number 23. Пушнатиян Адармина. Пушнатиян Адармина. Свабудхья там апандитам. Свабудхья там апандитам. Те критартхам прахинванти. Те критартхам прахинванти. Пранараех сутадеха. Пранараех сутадеха. Пушнатияна дармина. Свабудхья там апандитам. Те критартхам прахинванти. Пранараех сутадеха. Пушнатияна дармина. Свабудхья там апандитам. Те критартхам прахинванти. Пранараех сутадеха. Please. Атияна дармина. Будхе там апандитам. Те критархам прахинванти. Пранараех сутадеха. Натияна дармина. Будхья там апандитам. Итархам прахинванти. Пранараех сутадеха. Матаджис. Натияна дармина. Будхья там апандитам. Те критартхам прахинванти. Пранараех сутадеха. Word by word translation. Пушнати nourishes. Ян which thinks. Адармина by sinful activity. Свабудхья thinking them to be his own. Там, him. Апандитам, uneducated. Те, they. Акрита артхам, his purposes frustrated. Прахинванти, abandon. Пранаха, life air. Раяха, wealth. Сута адаяха, children and others. Translation and purport by sincere and humble disciples of His Divine Grace Abhaya Charnaravinda Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki jai, sincere and humble disciples ki jai. Translation. A fool indulges in sin to maintain his life, wealth and children and other relatives, for he thinks these things are mine. In the end, however, these very things all abandon him, leaving him frustrated. Purport. In these verses, Akrura is giving rather frank advice to Dhritarashtra. Those who know the story of the Mahabharata will realize how relevant and prophetic these instructions are, and how much Dhritarashtra suffered for not accepting them. Although one tenaciously clings to his property, in the end, all is lost, and the blundering soul is swept away by the will of birth and death. Ома гьяна тимирандася, гьянанджана шалакая, чакшур умилитам яна, тасмай шри гураве намага. Шри читани манухпиштам, стапитам ена бутале, сварупа кадама ям дадати сва падантикам. Ванча калпатарубьяща, крипа синубя эвача, патитанам паваны бьо, вайшнава бьо, намонамага. Джая Шри Кришна Чайтанья Прабу Нитьянанда Шри Адвайта Дадхара Шри Васади Гоура Бхакта Вринда Хри Кришна, Кришна Кришна, Хари Хари Хри Рама, Рама Рама, Хари Хари. In order to consider our knowledge about Bhakti Yoga and about process of Bhakti Yoga to be complete, we should not only we should know how to progress spiritually, but we also should know what are the impediments on this path. Otherwise, our knowledge is not complete. And otherwise, we cannot guarantee, no one can guarantee that our spiritual journey will be successful. So, Srimad Bhagavatam starts from the questions that were asked by Maharaja Parikshit to Shukadeva Goswami. And it goes in such way that these questions are asked. And at this moment, in this particular moment, the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam is finished, and the answers we can find in the beginning, from the beginning of the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. And the question were, what should a person do if he is about to leave his body? What he should do? What is his duty? And also, what should be done and what should not be done? And Shukadeva Goswami is answering on these questions in the first chapter of the second canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, he says that actually it is very important, very essential, if you are about to leave your body, it is very essential and important to be absorbed in Krishna consciousness through the processes of Kirtanam and Shravanam, through the processes of chanting Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So it was a particular process that was chosen by Maharaja Parikshit and was approved by all these sages that were on the bank of this sacred river, Ganges or Yamuna, according to Jiva Goswami, it was Yamuna River. Anyway, it was approved, and Maharaja Parikshit was sitting there and was absorbing his consciousness in all these Krishna's pastimes and pastimes of Krishna's devotees. It is the process. But at the same time, in this very first chapter of the second canto of Bhagavatam, Shukadeva Goswami, he says, who are Grihamedhis? And why it is not so nice to be Grihamedhi or to be envious person? Grihamedhi means householder. And why Shukadeva Goswami, he speaks about householders? Well, just because mostly people, they are inclined for family life. So mostly if we are speaking about people, we are saying that likely it is about those who are in family life, those who are husband of someone or wife of someone or children or of someone and so on and so on. So here, in the very first verses of the second canto of Bhagavatam, Srila Prabhupada, when he writes the purports on these verses, he explains that, it is not so good to be envious and selfish. Envious and selfish. These two qualities are pillars, it is foundation, it is pillars of materialistic mindset. And in today's purport, we can find, it is written here, that Dhritarashtra was suffering so much for not accepting Akrura's advices. Akrura's advices. So one who doesn't accept this advice that Bhakti Yoga, that Krishna consciousness should be the priority number one in one's life, he is destined to suffer. He is destined to suffer. That's why Shukadeva Goswami, he says in the very beginning of his instructions, he says, it is not good to be envious, it is not good to be selfish. And here he Srila Prabhupada he explains how this mindset works. The griha medhis, being interested in family affairs only, I would like to emphasize this, to emphasize this point, in family affairs only, in this case, are certainly envious of others. It is guaranteed. If my consciousness is about I and mine, and these things are mine, and I am focused only on my desires and only of what I consider to be it belongs to me. If my consciousness is such, then I will be envious to other people. And envious means two things. Envious means to be inimical. Inimical means others are enemies or they can become enemies. And another point regarding envy is that if someone is successful, I will be really unhappy because of his success. So how it works? In Chaitanya Charitamrita, in Antya Lila, we have this famous verse which describes the functioning of materialistic mind. Sei balo, sei manda, sei mano dharma. Say manodharma, manodharma, activity of a mind. To say bhalo, say manda. This is good and this is bad. These statements are created by conditioned mind. And it is just the product of materialistic mind. It is what materialistic mind generates, these ideas that something is good and something is bad. But what is the reason why mind considers something to be good or bad? Srila Prabhupada, he writes in his purport that the reason is that these people, they have materialistic plan how we're going to satisfy our senses. And if we have particular plan how I'm going to satisfy my senses, then naturally all these people who are around me, they are divided in two categories. Well, basically in three categories. Those who are my friends, means those who will be facilitating my sense enjoyment. Then those who create impediments, they are my enemies. And of course, there is some category of people who are neutral, who don't create any impediments, but at the same time, they don't help too much. But this perception is false because it is based on my own idea how I'm going to how I'm going to enjoy this material world. And this material world is not created for this. So this division, when a conditioned living entity is trying to divide living entities who are around him, to divide these living entities in the categories that someone is my enemy, someone is my friend, it is false perception. It is false perception. And actually when Prahlada Maharaj, when he gives his instructions to his schoolmates, he says, my dear friends, sons of demons, don't consider people who are around you to be your friends or to be your enemies. Don't divide. Don't divide. Better you preach Krishna consciousness and be friend of everyone. And to preach Krishna consciousness means to induce others to chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So here in today's verse, Akrura, he says to Dhritarashtra that some people, they are trying to achieve different material things, which are that are perishable, that are temporary. And at the same time, this category of people is devoid of Atmatattva science. And it is their misfortune. It is their misfortune that they are devoid of Atmatattva science. They are not interested of who they are, that they are spiritual souls. Because the natural conclusion, if I accept this science, that I'm spiritual soul, likely I will be searching for other treasures, not these perishable material treasures, but I will be trying to develop my Krishna consciousness. Because if I'm spiritual soul, if I'm not this body, then likely I will be trying to develop, to revive my eternal relationships with Krishna. But because they are not interested, it makes them unfortunate. And we can see, and everyone can see, every person who tries to do direct preaching, who tries to do book distribution, for example, quite often we meet such people when we try to distribute book, and person says, I'm not interested in, I'm not interested in, or I have no time, or even some people in Russia, they say, I don't read. Jokingly, but anyway, some people, they say like this. So different reasons why I'm not going to read these books. Picture, Srila Prabhupada, he was describing that there was one picture in one newspaper or in one magazine where one old lady and one old man were there on this picture, and it was written like this old lady, she says to her husband, chant, 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 very famous story, chant, 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 and this old man, he responds, can't, 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 I cannot chant. So the same way, some people are so stubborn, they don't want to chant holy names of Supreme Lord. We can see such category of people in Nagar Sankirtan on Harinam. Some people, they are passing away doing like this. They don't want to listen holy names. They don't want to listen holy names. And once, there was one case in one of Russian cities on Nagar Sankirtan. There was one case when we were chanting holy names of Krishna, of Supreme Lord Shri Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. We were chanting, and just on the opposite side, one person was standing in such posture, like he was protesting against our Nagar Sankirtan. And he was standing like this about 1 minute, like protesting and tolerating us. And then suddenly he shouted, Jesus Christ! And ran away. It was his response to our preaching. Confirmed. It was his response to our preaching. He didn't like holy names of Krishna, but he respected Jesus Christ. So you see, we can face different kinds of people when we are on preaching. Some people, they accept. Some people, they don't accept. But anyway, so Prahlada Maharaj, in his instructions to his schoolmates, he analyzes the duration of human life. The duration of human life is about 100 years, ideally. Of course, it is not that everyone is able to live till 100 years. So he analyzes and he says that about half of this lifetime, usually people, they spend on sleeping. Hare Krishna. On sleeping, they just sleep. They sleep at night, but it is not enough for them. They even sleep in daytime for a few hours more. So about half of lifetime, about 12 hours every day is wasted. Then the next period of life, it is about 20 years of lifetime. It is childhood, it is boyhood, when a person is engaged sporting and playing and so on and so on. And in old age, usually people are not so conscious what's going on with them. they are not so much conscious. So this time is also wasted. So we have some period of time in between where a person is conscious of what's going on with them because he is not old, he is not a newborn baby. He is conscious, but this attraction to family life, materialistic family life, is so strong that this particular period of time which is in between is also wasted. So Prahlada Maharaj, he says, don't waste your time. Don't waste your time. And Srila Prabhupada, when he writes the purport to these verses, he writes this such statement. At the end of 100 years, one who has not acted as a human being in a life of tapasya, austerity and penance, must certainly be embodied again in a body like those of cats and hawks and dogs. So basically, if all duration of life, if the whole 100 years is wasted, if tapodivyam or divine austerity didn't take any place, then body of dog or body of hog or body of camel or body of cat is guaranteed. And Srila Prabhupada, he compares Shri Shri Radha Rasa Bihari Ki Jai, Shri Shri Sitaram Lakshman Hanuman Ki Jai, Shri Shri Gauranitai Ki Jai. And Srila Prabhupada, he compares this samsara, this samsaric existence, with Ferris wheel. When you sit in Ferris wheel, and sometimes you are up, sometimes you are down. Means there are some lower species of life, like dogs, hogs, or even insects. And there are some forms of life, like human form of life, or demigods, or whatever. And again, this envy is all-pervading in material world. So those who are in the lower position of this Ferris wheel of samsara, they are envious to those who took the upper position. But this upper position is temporary because this Ferris wheel is always turning. So some people, they are envious to other people, and those people who are on the upper position, they are arrogant to those who are in lower position. And it turns, and there is variety. This materialistic existence gives some variety to living being. But anyway, it is, it has no sense. Actually, it has no sense. So we chant, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. We ask Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, please come and please engage me in devotional service. Please be manifested in my life. It is the same way, like, for example, we are in this Ferris wheel and we are disgusted with this Ferris wheel and we are calling for electrician to switch it off. Switch this Ferris wheel off. Dear electrician Prabhu, So the same way we chant holy names, we ask Supreme Lord Shri Krishna to engage us in devotional service. We want to take this shelter of Antaranga Shakti, of this divine energy. Дайви хеша гуна майи мама майя дуратея. This energy, this Mahamaya, is divine energy. Divine energy. And Srila Prabhupada, he explains, what does it mean, divine energy? Divine energy means that the supreme will of Krishna is executed by Mahamaya. Mahamaya doesn't act independently. She is the servant of Supreme Lord Shri Krishna. So, of course, she causes troubles for a living entity. But Дайви хеша гуна майи мама майя дуратея. It goes according to Krishna's supreme will. And Srila Prabhupada, he explains why it is so. He explains that Maya is testing us why we chant Hare Krishna. Why are we trying to do devotional service? What is our reason? Why we are chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. So Maya is testing. Why do you chant Hare Krishna, dear Prabhuji or dear Mataji? You chanting in order to serve Krishna. You are trying to approach Krishna in order to serve Krishna, or you are trying to approach Krishna to ask him for something, to ask him to fulfill your endless desires. So those who are about desires, they will be filtered. And those who are serious, those who are about devotional service, they will be accepted. So what we can get from this process of devotional service, again, there are materialistic achievements. Materialistic achievements are temporary and perishable. And it doesn't give any eternal happiness. And also, even the process, when one tries to achieve this materialistic goals, this process doesn't make living entity happy. Bhukti Mukti, Siddhi Kami, Sakale Ashanta. Those who want materialistic wealth, those who want liberation, those who want mystic powers, what's going on with them, they are Sakale Ashanta. They are always disturbed. So what one can do in order to be peaceful, and what kind of achievements one should be trying to get in order to be happy? It is natural to be happy. It is natural to have a desire to be happy. It is said in Vedanta Sutra that living entity is searching for bliss. Ananda Maya Bhyasat. It is the second sutra of Vedanta Sutra. Ananda Maya Bhyasat. Living entity is trying to find happiness, but does he knows or not where is this eternal happiness? Usually there is no knowledge. That's why we're very grateful to our spiritual masters who entered in our lives with torch of knowledge and gave us the understanding of what is real happiness. That's why we pronounce Ома Гьянати Мирандасья Гьянанджана Шалакая Чакшур Унмилитам Яна Тасмай Шри Гураве Намаха. Because one cannot become happy if he doesn't have proper understanding, proper conception of what is happiness. You can try to be happy, but if you don't know what is the nature of real happiness, and what is the source of happiness, then you can try for million and million of years, of lives, without any result. So, in the third canto of Bhagavatam, third canto, 23rd chapter, there is a story of Kardama Muni and Devahuti. And Devahuti was serving to Kardama Muni. And because she was serving to Kardama Muni, she has got the same achievements like Kardama Muni has got because of his tapasya, because of his meditation, because of his Krishna consciousness. Devahuti has got the same because she was a menial servant of Kardama Muni. And what exactly she has got? Kardama Muni, he says in the verse 3:23:7, although you have not yet experienced these achievements, which are free from fear and lamentation, I shall offer them all to you because you are engaged in my service. Now just look at them. And in purport, Srila Prabhupada explains what actually was achieved by Devahuti. What are the graces of the Lord? It is stated here that the graces of the Lord are abhaya, free from fearfulness, abhaya. And he gives the example, Srila Prabhupada he gives the example. In the material world, if someone accumulates $1,000,000, he is always full of fear because he is always thinking, what if the money is lost? It is the nature of materialistic, of material achievements. I achieve something and then it also goes with fear together. I am worried, I'm disturbed how not to lose it. But if to speak about spiritual achievements, it has another nature. But the benediction of the Lord, Bhagavat Prasada, is never to be lost. It is simply to be enjoyed. There is no question of loss. One simply gains and enjoys gaining. We chant holy names and we enjoy this gaining. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. А так Шри Кришна нам один обавит грахем индрия их, сивон мукехи джихвадоу, своем его спуратядах. Very famous verse from Padma Purana. Spiritual life, devotional service starts from джихва. Сивон мукехи джихвадоу, starts from джихва. Starts from two activities of the tongue. When we take prasada, when we chant holy names. There is no loss. It is very simple process. To take prasadam is very simple. To chant holy names is very simple. After some time we are going to take prasadam, we are going to implement this knowledge in practice. Yeah. So it is not so difficult and there is no loss. Like for example, in one letter to his Japanese disciples, Srila Prabhupada, he wrote that you can chant these holy names everywhere. When you go from your house to your job, when you go from your job to your house, you also can chant Hare Krishna. When you have a walk, when you do something, when you go to shop, when you go from shop, you can chant holy names, you can chant Hare Krishna. It is very easy and it is for free. It is for free. You don't have to pay anything for chanting Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. It is actually matchless gift. Holy name is matchless gift. We didn't pay anything for Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. I suppose there is no one here in this hall, in this audience, who was charged some money for Hare Krishna Maha Mantra. Usually it is given for free, right? Usually it is given for free. So how we can get these spiritual achievements? How we can get Krishna consciousness? How we can get this fearless? How we can do it? Devahuti, she was serving Tukardama Muni, and in that way she has got these achievements. What we can do? Who is our Kardama Muni? Who is our Kardama Muni? Who taught? You. Srila Prabhupada. Right. And spiritual master. Both of you are right. Hare Krishna. Yes, that's right. So let's read from this purport to the verse number 3, 23, 7, Srila Prabhupada explains how it works. For spiritual achievement, the easiest path is to take shelter of a bona fide spiritual master and to serve him with heart and soul. That is the secret of success. As stated by Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur in his 8 stanzas of prayer to the spiritual master, Yasya Prasadat Bhagavat Prasada. By serving or receiving the grace of the spiritual master, one receives the grace of the Supreme Lord. By serving her devotee husband, Kardama Muni, Devahuti shared in his achievements. Similarly, a sincere disciple, simply by serving a bona fide spiritual master, can achieve all the mercy of the Lord and the spiritual master simultaneously. Just by serving. And it is the question of consciousness. Are we aware, are we conscious that what we are doing is our service to spiritual master or not? Because there is a tendency to practice Krishna consciousness automatically, yes, because for mind it is easier to do everything automatically, but then it doesn't work. And what should we do? For example, there is one famous verse from Srimad Bhagavatam. Shushrushok shradadhanasya vasudeva katha ruchih syan mahat sevaya vipra punya tirtha nishevanat. Which means that if one serves to great souls, to pure devotees, or basically speaking it is written punya tirtha. Punya tirtha means those who have no faults, devotees who have no imperfections. Then vasudeva katha ruchih. Vasudeva katha ruchih means the taste for vasudeva katha or for Krishna katha, or basically speaking in our case, for reading Srila Prabhupada's books, is there. If this syan mahat seva vipra, if this seva takes place, it is the way how we can get or how we can revive our taste to read Srila Prabhupada's books if we have some difficulties in this. If these books looks like something boring, then we have to serve to great souls. We have to serve to pure devotees. And some people, especially if to speak about small communities, small congregations, they can tell that we don't have punya tirthas. We don't have punya tirthas. We don't have such perfect devotees, and we have no one to serve. But it is not true, because everywhere, in every temple, Srila Prabhupada is presented in form of his murti, which is not different from himself. And just when we do something in ISKCON temple, or in Bhakti Vriksha, or for devotees, or whatever, we do some small service, some menial service. And if at this particular moment, when we are conscious, if we are conscious that we are doing this for Srila Prabhupada's satisfaction and for our spiritual master's satisfaction, then the result is that syan mahat sevaya vipra punya tirtha nishevanat. We should just remind ourselves that we are doing this, even small thing, even menial service, we do it for Srila Prabhupada's satisfaction, for spiritual master satisfaction. And then we will be able to see that this taste to read this wonderful spiritual, blissful, and so on, Srila Prabhupada's books, this taste will be increasing and increasing if we serve with understanding that actually we serve. Not that we are doing something because someone asked us to do this, but I don't want, but I have to. It is not the mood of service. Mood of service is to satisfy spiritual master and to satisfy Srila Prabhupada. To satisfy means I want Srila Prabhupada, I want to see Srila Prabhupada happy. And I want to see my spiritual master happy of what I'm doing. And His Holiness Srila Niranjana Swami Maharaj, on one of his classes that he gave in December of, I don't remember which year, the class was about book distribution marathon. So His Holiness Srila Niranjana Swami Maharaj, he was remembering how he was brahmachari in US, in Boston Temple. And he says that we were ready to put any endeavors, just in order to see the grateful smile on Srila Prabhupada's face. Because when such person like Srila Prabhupada, when he smiles, when it is visible that he is satisfied with you, then it gives very real and deep inner happiness to the practitioner, to the devotee. So it is important. It is important. The devotional service is not about some formal accomplishment of some duties. It is not dry practice. It is not dry practice. There is particular person who is Krishna's representative, and we want to develop particular spiritual qualities that will make us closer to Krishna. And this Krishna's representative, he has these qualities. And if we are attracted by these qualities, then it is good. And if we want to satisfy this Krishna's representative, then there is a chance that we will get these qualities. It works like this. So again, we speak together about achievements. There are different achievements. There are materialistic achievements that are perishable, temporary, and there is another category of achievements, spiritual achievements, that are very valuable, and one doesn't lose this achievement. Нишабхикрамо нашусти пратьявайорна видяте свалпапасе дармасе траете махато баят. It is the nature of this path of bhakti. You do some advancement, some spiritual advancement in Krishna consciousness. Then, if you didn't achieve perfection, next life you begin from the same point. You don't lose anything. It is very good. It is the difference between material achievements and spiritual achievements. Srila Prabhupada gives very well-known example with the skyscraper. The person decides to build the skyscraper. But suddenly he leaves his body and he cannot finish this project. He cannot interact with this project anymore. No, this story is finished. And then he takes another birth, which is not obviously will be related with this skyscraper. But if he so much was attached to this project, to this skyscraper, then Krishna is very merciful. He can help. He can help this particular living entity to take birth in this skyscraper, but because human form of life is not guaranteed, it can be form of life of cockroach, for example, or mosquito or cockroach or whatever. So better to be attached to our spiritual plans, which is not perishable. We leave this body, then next life starts, and we don't lose any fruits of our endeavors. We don't lose anything. That's why better to be focused on this devotional service and on chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. In the fourth canto of Bhagavatam, where the Puranjana, the king story is described, in one of the purports, Srila Prabhupada writes that when disciple is initiated, he should be just focused on executing his spiritual master's instructions, and he should not be worried. He should not be disturbed, he should not think, he should not be anxious about will he achieve spiritual abode or not. Because actually it is not his area of responsibility, it is the area of responsibility of his spiritual master. He should be just focused on executing the instructions of a spiritual master. I have seen some devotees in Russia, mainly brahmacharis, who were so anxious, so worried about their imperfect nature, and they were roaming here and there and thinking, will I achieve this parama artha or not? Will I achieve or not? Because I'm unworthy, I'm not qualified, and so on and so on. It is how the mind works. Mind works like this. So the advice is given, Srila Prabhupada, he gives the advice that mind should be observed in the practice of devotional service. Of course, it depends on Krishna's mercy. It is not, it is not that there is some particular sequence of our actions that we do, and then the result is guaranteed, that we will achieve this spiritual abode. Ultimately, it depends on Krishna's will. If he agrees, then it will happen. If not, then not. So, to be devoted to Supreme Lord means I accept his supreme will. I agree. I'm ready to wait as long as it will be needed. Some people can be worried, oh, I'm not going to achieve this highest goal of life in one lifetime, so why should I struggle? And so it can take, we don't know how many lives it can take. It can take one life, it can take 10, it can take million of lives. But anyway, the determination should be there. Determination of that anyway, I will be chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. In one of the letters, Srila Prabhupada writes, this letter was written in 1975. This letter was written to the disciple Mataji. Her name is Krishna Nandini, and Srila Prabhupada writes in this letter, make the best out of a bad bargain. This material body is a bad bargain because it is always miserable. So to make the best out of this bad bargain means to render devotional service in any circumstance. In any circumstance. The same idea of this readiness to perform devotional service in any circumstances, we can find in very well-known verse from Bhagavad Gita, verse 14:26. 14:26. Mamchayo vyabhicharina bhakti yogena sevate sagunan samatityaitan brahma buyaya kalpate. Which means, one who engages in full devotional service, unfailing in all circumstances, at once transcends the modes of material nature and thus comes to the level of Brahman. In the purport, Srila Prabhupada, he explains that the level of Brahman is actually the level of Parabrahman, the level of Krishna. Means to come to the level of Brahman means to achieve spiritual abode, to achieve Goloka or Krishna Loka. So again, this verse 14.26 is about readiness to practice in different circumstances. Матрас паршас тукаун тияши тошна сукха дукхадах. Агамапая на нитя стам ститикша сабарата. We are conditioned souls. And it means that we need some conditions for executing our devotional service. But the same way, if we are able to tolerate the duality of this material existence, the more we are able to tolerate, the better. Because, you know, it is not that the happy day will come and the ideal circumstances will be around us. It is always that something is good, something is bad. His Holiness Niranjana Swami Maharaj, again I'm mentioning him, he told in one class that there is such category of people, such category of devotees, or better to say, category of Krishna friends, so-called Krishna friends, who says that I have some goals in my life, materialistic goals, how to arrange my life, how to arrange it ideally. And when everything will be settled ideally, then I will be peacefully sitting and chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Unfortunately, there is a great chance that this day will never happen, because, dear friends, we live in Kali Yuga, and it is not that our karma is so nice. In this particular period of life, we have some troubles, but it is not guaranteed. Likely, it is guaranteed that the next period we will have another kind of troubles, but troubles are always there. It is the nature of material existence. So, tolerance, it is one of the qualities which is really needed in spiritual life. And not only in spiritual life, in life in general. Life in general, it requires the tolerance. But even if someone wants to achieve some materialistic goal, it means he should be stable in his endeavors. It means also he should be tolerant. In any condition of life, is person practitioner of spiritual life or he is materialist, anyway the tolerance is needed. But what is the nature of tolerance in Krishna consciousness? What do we tolerate all these discomforts and so on? Srila Prabhupada, he explains in one of the purports to Bhagavatam that devotee's motive to tolerate is to satisfy Supreme Lord Shri Krishna. Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, he is in the heart of each and every living entity, and he is able to see, are we serious or not about our spiritual life? And if he sees that what price we pay, and do we pay some price or not, and what kind of endeavors we put, everything is well known by Krishna. We don't need and we don't have to be glorified by our friends, brahmacharis, or community, or congregation. There is no need to spread our glory. There is no need to do it, because even if no one knows about our endeavors, what is the most important that Supreme Lord Shri Krishna knows about our endeavors? And he remembers our endeavors very nicely. He is Trikalagya. Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, Trikalagya. He knows past, present, future. And this glory, this mundane glory, is very temporary. It is also materialistic achievement. It is also materialistic achievement. Because all these people who will be remembering about our achievements, they will live for some time, and they will also, after some time, they will also leave their bodies. And that's all. And no one is glorifying us anymore because they are dead. But Krishna, he always remembers about our endeavors in devotional service. And he helps us and he supports us on each and every step of our spiritual life. If we didn't achieve perfection in this life, he will help us to continue with this practice next life. Hare Krishna, do you have any questions? Yeah. Please take the mic.
Hare Krishna. Thank you very much, Murli Madhav Murari. Thank you, Madhav Murari Prabhu. So, here in India, we are preaching to the youngsters. So, they take some time to come to Krishna consciousness. But when Indian youngsters see Westerners like you, they feel guilty, and sometimes they feel inspired.
Okay.
Yeah. So, I would like to know how you came to Krishna consciousness. What was the initial seed?
It is long story.
So, make it shorter.
It is long story. Well, I already told this story on Sunday program, on this Master of Excellence program. I went to the temple. I was just passing by, and My godbrother means the devotee who became later on my godbrother, because later on I was initiated after some time. So I went to the temple first time, and the Sunday feast was going on. Actually, this Sunday feast was about to finish. So this devotee, he approached me and he told, sit and eat, sit and eat. And I sat, and he gave me the plate with halwa, and I asked him how much it is, and he told it is for free, and I was very happy. I took this halwa, and then he asked me how do you find it, and I told it was very tasty, and he asked, would you like to see how do we cook it? And I told yes, and we went to the kitchen, and he showed me the kitchen, and he told me, can you see these pots? In these pots, we are cooking this nice halwa, and you, if you will wash these pots, you will become even much more happy, because Krishna will be satisfied. Just put an experiment, he told me, just put an experiment. So I put the experiment, and I could feel that really the happiness increased to some extent. Such stories. So, and now I'm sitting before all of you and trying to explain the nature of this divine process. Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much, Prabhu.
You are welcome, Hare Krishna. Some more questions? Devotees, ask at least one more question, please. Yeah, please give the mic to the devotee.
Praji, you in the starting phase, you discussed about two defects of Dhritarashtra, selfishness and enviousness. So we see among devotees also, sometimes it has been observed that someone is being selfish and envious of other devotee. So how one can come out of it?
Oh, very nice. One should become absorbed in Krishna consciousness for long period of time, long, for decades, in order to become situated, first of all, to become situated in mode of goodness. Mode of goodness. So, it is important to become free from envy. Once Radha Govinda Prabhu, he is Shivarama Swami's disciple from Moldova. Moldova, it is the country. And Radha Govinda Prabhu, he has got the, he is empowered as an initiating guru in ISKCON. So he is an ISKCON initiating guru from Moldova, Radha Govinda Das. So once he was asked the question, what about friendship in Krishna consciousness? What is required? What qualities are required to have friendship in Krishna consciousness? So he answered that actually one should achieve Madhyama Adhikari level. Madhyama Adhikari level, because otherwise, if one is not Madhyama Adhikari, then likely all the relationships in which this person will be entering will be more or less contaminated by envy. So friendship, it is not something cheap. It requires purity. It requires purity. Again, Madhyama Adhikari level starts from Nishtha, starts from firm faith, starts from this situation when one is situated in mode of goodness. So it requires years and likely decades of this Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti process. And how this process helps? It helps us to establish Krishna in the center of our life. In the center of our life. We can be brahmacharis or grihasthas or sannyasis or vanaprasthas. It depends on a person, but the idea is to put Krishna in the center of one's life. And if one is practicing for a long time, for years, for decades, then naturally his mindset will be changed. His mindset will be changed. And these qualities, spiritual qualities, also will be manifested in the heart. So again, what is required, Utsaha Nishchaya Daryat, nectar of instruction, verse number 3, Utsaha Nishchaya Daryat, Daryat means it takes time. Daryat means tolerance, patience, it takes time. Utsaha Nishchaya, Nishchaya, determination, Utsaha, enthusiasm, these qualities are required. Just go on with this process and be satisfied with this process. Just be happy that you are in the process. Don't lament that you didn't achieve the perfection yet. When we are in the process, it is also interesting. Hare Krishna. Grantarat Srimad Bhagavatam Kijai. Srila Prabhupada Kijai. Nitya Gaura Premananda. Hare Krishna.